Hi there and welcome back to the Dagger in the Day YouTube channel. This video is going to be about the M31 canteen. So right here, these are the canteens that I own. Two with the felt covers and one coconut canteen. This one's all original with the original Bakelite cup on it. Original leather straps. This one is a little bit more worn out. This one has an original Heinrich Ritter cup, and the straps are reproduction, but the hardware is original but repainted in an awful color. This one is not a canteen that I'm going to use, neither is that, basically because this one is going to crack. This one is already cracking right there. This one, it's the one that I use for reenacting. It's an original VVNS marked canteen, which stands for Vereinigte Deutsche Nickelwerke Schwerte. It's a 1940 marked, I believe. The strap is reproduction, the cup is a reproduction, and this hook is of course also reproduction, and quite bad one actually, but it's going to be replaced, which I'm going to show you in a few minutes. Basically, originals are marked in three places. It's going to be on the top here. As you can see, this one has of course the VDNS marking. They are also marked there, and they are marked on the inside of the cover. So I like to use the large aluminum cups instead of the small Bakelite cups. They are more sturdy, they are going to last longer, and they are more usable in the field because you can make coffee or tea in them on top of your Azbit cooker. So this is the reproduction that I use. As you can see, it's marked TSR. These are Sturm MealTech reproductions. I also have a Sturm MealTech Spork, which also has the TSR marking. I really recommend Sturm reproduction items like this, because these are quite well made. They are quite true to the originals. As you can see, these are not very, very different. This, of course, is my original one, with no paint left, but it used to be black. And this is HRE, so Heinrich Ritter Aluminium Esslingen. So yeah, I recommend using a reproduction like this, because you're not going to notice the difference, and I believe these are mostly sold for around 9 or 10 euros or dollars, so not very expensive. If you want to use these ones, go for reproduction. Don't use an original, because you are going to destroy it. These are quite fragile, so they are going to break. If you're going to use a canteen, at least this is what I'm going to do in mine. This is the hook that's on the strap already. It's a metal one. It's quite ugly. It is sturdy, but I'm not going to keep it on there. I bought this original hook in France on a yard sale for around 50 cents. I believe so. If you can find something like this on a yard sale, you can put it on there. It's going to look way better. I'm going to do that once I learn how to sew leather. So there are a few things you need to keep in mind when you buy a canteen for your reenactment impression. One thing is to not buy the metal canteens. These are all aluminum on the inside. So basically that part where my nail is right there, that needs to be aluminum. If you buy the metal ones, you're going to get poisoned probably. Also, don't use original leather straps on there. These ones are fine, these small cross straps that hold all the strap in place, but not the large strap that keep the cup and the cap in place. Those are going to rip on you. Don't use originals of those. Also, try to stay away from Bakelite caps, because those are also quite fragile, just like the cups, and those might break on you, which would be very sad because of course they are originals. So there are some vendors that sell parts or reproduction parts for canteens. If you want, you can also put a canteen together from reproduction parts. I mean, all of it, the strap, the cap, the cup, the canteen itself, the strapping. You can buy everything from certain vendors. I wrote some down that have parts on their sites. At the front, sell some complete, but you need to buy the separate cover for it because they don't have the little stars on them. Also Kelly's sells parts. Nestov also sells the caps and the little nails for them. So, and also the gaskets that go inside to keep the water in. So that might be a good idea if you want proper reproduction cap for your canteen. Also Hiki Shop sells some stuff. If you want more information about the canteens and all the stuff that you can buy for them from the vendors, I suggest you go to the Soldaten forum. I'm going to link it down below in the description. Also, the German World Tattoo Reenactor Facebook page, also a very nice place to ask questions and find information about and reviews about the reproduction parts that some vendors sell. So, one more thing that I wanted to tell you. My canteen, if you listen, that is the cap for the canteen. Always keep the cap open from the canteen. So otherwise you're going to get some mold or some things are going to grow in there that you don't want to grow in there because you want to drink out of this thing. So keep the cap off. Just a little tip. You should always do that, not just with these ones, but everything you're going to drink out of. For example, on hikes, also might be anything. Just if you're going to drink out of it, keep it open so it can't get moldy or stuff. So basically, that's going to be all for now. I thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Please go down in the description and go to the Soldaten forum or the Facebook page to ask more questions to people who know more than I do. I have learned a lot on those pages, so might be a good thing to check out if you haven't already. So thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed, and I see you in the next one.